What's up, everyone, and welcome back to Top 5 Central. Today we're looking at the top 10 popular YouTubers that have been hidden in TV shows. Now, YouTube has become a huge platform for the bigger people to make that jump to some of your favorite TV shows. And today we'll take a look at some of the more secret appearances to shows you may watch. Now, if we could break 5,000 likes on this video, I'll actually make a part 2 to this video. And instead of doing TV shows, I'll do movies, so make sure to absolutely smash the like button. With that said, let's get right into the video. Number 10, Sam Pepper. Before he became one of the most hated YouTube pranksters on the site, Sam Pepper had already had a brush with fame in the UK. In 2010, 2 years before his first video on YouTube, Sam Pepper was a part of the 11th season on the UK game show Big Brother. He entered the Big Brother house 52 days into the season's run and was evicted 21 days later on day 73. During his stay in the house, Sam Pepper was essentially one of the mischievous characters, basically causing trouble wherever he could. He managed to avoid eviction on day 66, but wasn't able to avoid the quadruple eviction event on day 73, where he got 14.6% of the public vote.
Sam! Sam, it's now time for you to say your goodbyes. I'm coming to get you!
I love you, all right? I love you,
Lee.
Yeah, that's cool.
Oh,
sorry.
Thanks.
Yeah,
I'll be in a minute,
mate. Yeah. Yeah, I'm so glad you're gone.
I'll see you in a few days.
I'll see you soon, buddy.
Sammy.
So pleased I got to know you.
Yeah, Andrew.
So pleased I got to know you.
I didn't see that at all. I thought you next
time. Number 9, Jenna Marbles. In 2015, the YouTuber Jenna Marbles made an appearance on a show called The Millionaire Matchmaker. The show is pretty much what you would expect it to be. It's a reality show about a matchmaker who struggles to keep her own life on track while also running a matchmaking business dedicated to matching wealthy people. In episode 7 of season 8, Jenna was roped in to try and help train two men in the difficult art of interacting with single women. The whole episode was basically Jenna trading insults with the other two guys and giving them a makeover.
Eye contact, honest eye contact. I want to feel like I'm having a real conversation.
Start over, ready?
Yes.
Hi.
How are you?
Jenna.
Chris.
Nice to meet you. That was so good. What do you do for a living?
I have restaurants and back in New Jersey.
Okay, I really like that. Yeah. How would you have a conversation with me?
I like your dyed gray hair, which is kind of like old lady hair.
Really?
Number 8, Miranda Sings. Miranda Sings, aka the fictional character created by Colleen Ballinger, has managed to get over 7 million subscribers on her channel. The character is all about being over the top, and she actually made a guest appearance on the Nickelodeon show Victorious. The show ran from 2010 to 2013. It was all about a 16-year-old girl who had been invited to go to a crazy art school in Hollywood. In the episode, Miranda Sings sent an audition video for the Platinum Music Awards in the episode called Tori Goes Platinum. In classic Miranda Sings style, her character was dressed in crazy clothing and everything she did was seriously over the top. After watching the audition, the characters on the show didn't really know how to respond to her singing or her appearance.
The old Tori goodbye. Will Tori Vega become Tori Diva?
It's just
what?
Complicated.
There's only one way to find out.
Number 7, Todrick Hall. With over 2 million subscribers on YouTube, it's safe to say that Todrick Hall's singing has made him a pretty popular guy. But before he became YouTube famous, he was trying to become famous through a completely different path, American Idol. In 2010, which is a year before he started making videos on YouTube regularly, Todrick made his first appearance on the US talent show. In his first audition, he sang a song that he had written specifically for the judges, basically asking them how far did he need to go to get through the next rounds. Well, it turns out all he needed to do was sing as well as he could, because he ended up getting a total of 4 yeses. Unfortunately, Todrick wasn't destined to win American Idol, and he came 15th in the competition. Now, the good thing is that he didn't let that get him down, because he now has a thriving YouTube channel.
Be a dog. Tell me, do I have to dress up like I'm from a crazy house and sing like William Hung for you to see? There's some potential in little old me. And tell me, do I have to get down on my knees in my $300 jeans? Cause I would. If it meant to me, then maybe you could just send me to Hollywood.
Thank you.
Number 6, Bo Burnham. Bo Burnham is a comedian by trade, and sometimes he posts videos up on YouTube. Even though he usually only posts like 3 or 4 videos a year, his channel's managed to get over 1 million subscribers. Not only that, he's actually appeared in the comedy show Parks and Recreation. In In 2014, he appeared on the episode Flu Season 2, and his character was apparently the most amazing 17-year-old country and western singer of the world. And as well, his fans were called chipmunks? I don't know, Jesus Christ, dude.
2 million hits on YouTube.
Well, she don't care about no fancy trend. She's just a mom from Old South Bend.
Get home safe, boys, and thank you for protecting our freedom.
Let's play it again.
I'll bring the girls, you bring the beer, and the troops will bring the freedom.
So, we're sorry to interrupt, Chip. Oh. Hi, we just wanted to say we are such big fans. It's an honor to meet you.
Yeah, well, I'm very blessed. It's always nice to meet my...
Number 5, Adam Conover. While Adam Conover has his own gaming channel with almost 50,000 subscribers, he's most known for his work on the True TV YouTube channel where he posts a series called Adam Ruins Everything. As well, he's known for his work on College Humor. Now, not only is Adam a YouTuber, he also works as a voice actor, and one of the shows he worked on was the animated comedy BoJack Horseman. He's voiced in 14 episodes in the series in a load of minor roles. The most obvious of these roles is the character Bradley Hitler Smith, the ginger kid with the glasses from Horsin' Around. And basically, he just uses his standard voice. Number 4, Sufficiently Advanced. Alan Pan is the owner of the mechanical invention channel Sufficiently Advanced. He's mostly known for bringing things from movies like Thor's hammer and a real lightsaber and making them in real life. That's why he was chosen for a new game show that is currently airing known as Mythbusters: The Search. For those of you who don't know, the old classic Mythbusters team split up last year, and Mythbusters: The Search is a new show to find up-and-coming constructive talents to take over the roles in a brand new Mythbusters series. The show currently has 3 episodes, and Alan hasn't been knocked out yet, but as fellow YouTubers were sort of hoping, he'll win the whole thing and become a new Mythbuster.
Best of the best, your engineers and makers, to find out if you all have what it takes to be one of the Mythbusters.
I've been watching Mythbusters since day one. I'm so excited at this point, my hairs are actually standing up on end.
To be a Mythbuster, you obviously need to know about a few things. Science, engineering, but then there's also this ability to take abstract concepts and make them fun.
As new Mythbusters, we get to do what they did, but for our own way, for our own thing.
I can barely contain myself. I can't wait to get out there and just...
Number 3, Logan and Jake Paul. Logan and Jake Paul started their entertainment careers on Vine, but have managed to make themselves just as big on YouTube with their prank, vlog, and skit videos. But Jake managed to take things a step further by becoming one of the main cast of the new Disney show called Bizardvark. The show follows 2 teenage friends who make videos on a website called Voogle. It's basically a teen comedy take on YouTube culture. In the 7th episode of the show, Logan Paul made an appearance too, playing the part of a character called Kirk. In the show, Kirk is the brother of the character Dirk, who is of course played by Jake Paul. In the episode, Dirk is convinced to stop doing dangerous dares, and his brother Kirk is worried that his daredevil spirit has been broken for good.
When's the big nitrogen launcher trampoline basketball hot coals dare?
Sorry, Kirk, but thanks to Paige, I'm not doing dangerous dares anymore. Only safe ones.
What have you done to dare me, bro? Now there's nobody to do the...
Number 2, Lily Singh. Jake and Logan aren't the only YouTubers who have shown up in the comedy take on YouTube. Another popular YouTuber who has shown up on the Disney Channel show is Lily Singh. In the episode, she played herself, or rather her YouTube personality, Superwoman. One of the main characters was hoping to surprise one of the other main characters with a special ultimate guest at her birthday party, Lily Singh. Now the episode hasn't released yet, but will actually be coming out this Friday on the Disney Channel. Number 1, PewDiePie. How could we make a list of YouTubers being on TV shows without mentioning when PewDiePie showed up on South Park in 2014? The episode was all about the confusion with why some people didn't want to play video games but instead watch people commentating over video games. PewDiePie played himself, occasionally showing up throughout the show playing games like Call of Duty Advanced Warfare and Dragon Age. The episode actually did a pretty good job of highlighting things like the generational gap between our YouTube generation and the older generations of people who don't really get it. That, and it was pretty funny in the classic South Park way.
That's not the bullet, and I gotta run! Run for the bunker! Run!
Hi! We can go play the game downstairs! Isn't that better than watching some guy on YouTube playing it?
Alright, I hope that's enough. Meh. Like I said, look at this! Look at this!
Oh, great!
Dude, I'm telling you, it's crazy. All my little brother wants to do is sit on YouTube watching this PewDiePie play video games. I swear, I don't understand kids these days. What's a PewDiePie do? Google him. He's this guy.
And there's our video on the top 10 YouTubers hidden in TV shows. If you enjoyed the video, please feel free to leave a like down below and subscribe so you see whenever we upload a video. Also, if you have your own top 5 or top 10 idea, feel free to use your extremely handy form in the description to submit it. With that said, thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you all in the next video. Thank you.